on the Eagle River, and I wanted to share a couple things on how to properly handle fish. It's been a lot of discussion on hot water temperatures throughout the summer, and one of the biggest ways we can do our part as anglers is by reducing the amount of stress that we put on the fish. So why hot water matters is because the hotter the water gets, the lower the amount of oxygen in the water. So when these fish are swimming in cool water, they have a decent amount of oxygen, they're happy. When they get into the hot water, it's not enough oxygen, so they are incurring some stress. And then when we catch them in hot water, it puts a lot of stress on the fish, and stress is directly related to their mortality rates. So a couple things we can do. Let's start with the gear. When you guys, I have this sweet little stone fly imitation. When you guys are out with your hooks, pinch the barbs. The barbs on these hooks for catch and release fishing are not needed. If you're gonna let this fish go, if you're gonna let any fish go, pinch the barb. You can still catch a fish. It's sportier without it anyway. Next is the net. All the new nets have this rubbery material. Why this is important is because this rubbery material helps keep the slime on the fish's skin. The slime that's surrounding the fish is its immune system. So anytime we peel that slime off in any way, it's not good for the fish. It puts undue stress on the fish. So when you get a fish, in order to keep that slime on the fish, you want to take any pieces of fabric, any sun gloves, move them away. You want to get your hands wet, okay? Wet skin is the best way to handle a fish. For this video, I'm going to use a rock because I didn't want to stress the fish out to make a video about not stressing fish out. So if we'll pretend this is our fish, we hooked it, fought it for a little bit, we brought it into our net, and now what? So the biggest thing is get your hands wet. When you handle this fish, really the only reason you need to handle it is to get the hook out of its mouth. So if you can do that quickly, that's preferred. In the water is always preferred as well. Remember, that's how they breathe. So anytime you're pulling that fish out of the water, whether it's for a picture or to take the hook out, remember, it's not getting anything. It's basically not breathing. So as much as you can in the water. If you take a picture, you can kind of tilt your net down and keep it in the water. This water is super clear, so it's easy to get a picture if you have to in the water. And then you can use hashtag keep it wet, or keep it wet. Keep on wet. The fish should always be released upstream. So the water's flowing this way. That's how the fish is getting oxygen through its gills. When you release that fish, you should do your part to make sure that that fish is revived. So it's not just taking the hook out, throwing it over your shoulder, it's fine, it was alive. The fish has a high chance of dying if you don't revive it. So we're gonna take this fish into some current. We're gonna put his head in the water, upstream, and we're gonna let him sit there as long as he wants until he has had enough oxygen that he remembers where he's at and kicks out of your hand. When you're handling trout, there's nothing on him that's gonna hurt you, so you don't need to lip the fish. You don't need to squeeze it super hard. Just be gentle with the fish and get it back in the water and on its merry way as soon as possible. So I hope this was helpful. Feel free to share it. And I think if we all do our part, we can definitely keep this resource thriving and healthy for the rest of the summer. So good luck.